guys, this is Nandish from Aja Physics, and today we will see free body diagram. So we will be looking at what is free body diagram and its uses with some examples. So generally, when we are studying the mechanical systems, usually we will come across two cases. One is the mechanical system will be in equilibrium. Okay, so what do you mean by equilibrium? The word equilibrium means net external force on the mechanical system is equal to zero. So when the net external force on the mechanical system is zero, velocity of that system is going to be either zero or constant, which means acceleration of the system is going to be zero. This is called mechanical equilibrium. Similarly, the same system can be non-equilibrium. Okay. In such case, exactly opposite to the previous one, net external force is not equal to zero, where velocity is going to be not constant, which means acceleration is not zero. So this free body diagram will help us to visualize number of forces, moments and reactions on a mechanical system. Let us see how this free body diagram will help us. Let me go with an example. So here we have a block of mass M which is placed on the rough surface. You know that rough surface will provide the friction force, and this is acted upon by an external force called F. And still, even under this external force, assume that the object is not moving anywhere. That means its velocity is zero, or it is not changing its velocity from zero. That is why the velocity is said to be constant. In the second case, the same block, when it is acted upon by an external force F, assume that it is moving along the direction of the force you applied, and when it is moving, assume that its acceleration is equal to A. So this is stable equilibrium case and this is non-equilibrium case. Now to write the free body diagram for these two cases, we have to follow three steps. The first step is we will neglect all the surroundings but this block of mass M. Let me show you how to write the free body diagram. The first step is we have to neglect the surrounding, everything, but we have to write only the block of mass M. So let me write the block of mass M. This is what the first step in writing the free body diagram. Okay. So now, assume that this block of mass M is in a plane. It is in the plane of the board now. So we have to take the two coordinate axes, X and Y. Okay. So usually, as usually, we will take this is X axis and we will be taking this is the Y axis. So both the negative X axis and positive X axis will be there. Similarly, negative Y axis and positive Y axis will be there. And in the next step, we have to figure out for this stable equilibrium. We are writing for the stable equilibrium case where the velocity is not changing. I mean, the object is not accelerating anywhere. That means the net force must be zero, as we have discussed earlier. Now, for the net case to be zero, we will figure out on this object how many forces are acting along the x-axis first. The first thing is, in the diagram itself it is shown, along the positive x-axis there is a force, there is an applied force. Let me call that applied force as F. And it is not moving along the x-axis because I told velocity is not changing. Therefore, there must be opposite force to this applied force. That opposite force is none other than the static friction provided by the rough surface. So therefore, along the negative x-axis, opposite to this, there must be one more force. Let me call this force as Fs, where Fs is the static friction, which is given by mu s into n. Mu s is constant, called as coefficient of static friction, and this n is actually the force which is along the positive y axis. Let me tell you what is that. Now we have written the forces which are acting, the possible forces are acting along the x axis on this block. Similarly, along the y-axis also, there are two forces. One is, as usually we know that along the negative y-axis, the force acting on the block is mg, its own weight. And opposite to this mg, there is one more force must be acting, that is called as normal reaction. Okay, that normal reaction is called as N. So here, for the stable equilibrium, in the first case, these two forces are equal and opposite along the x-axis. Similarly, these two forces must be equal and opposite along the y-axis, and hence the object is not changing its velocity anywhere. So this diagram, okay, so where the block and there is no surrounding, but surrounding is filled with the forces, okay, that we are representing the forces, the possible forces acting on the block of mass m. And now by using this free body diagram, we can write the dynamic equations. How to write them? It is very simple. Now, even to write the dynamic equations also, we'll go with the axis only. First, I will be writing the force, I mean the dynamic equation along the x-axis. For that, I take these two forces, and as usually you know that any forces which is directed along the positive x-axis will be taken as positive, and any forces which is along the negative x-axis will be taken as negative. Therefore, the net force acting along the x-axis is given by F plus minus of Fs, that must be equal to 0. I wrote directly it is equal to 0 because there is no acceleration of the block along the x-axis. So this can be written as this plus into minus is minus, Fs is equal to 0. This is one of the dynamic equations along the x-axis. Similarly, along the y-axis for this case can be written as, one is N. So here any forces along the positive y-axis will be taken as positive, and downward forces, I mean along the negative x y-axis, we will be taken as negative only. So therefore, the net force acting along the y-axis will be N plus minus mg must be equal to 0. So this is also equal to 0 because object is not accelerating along the y-axis. Therefore, the net force along the y-axis must be equal to 0. So finally, and as usually, N minus mg is equal to 0. So these two are the dynamic equation that can be written easily by using this free body diagram. So here, free body diagram is doing nothing but help us to visualize the forces and their directions. Similarly, in the second case, where the block is in non-equilibrium because it is accelerating along the x-axis, it is not accelerating along the y-axis. So therefore, to write the free body diagram, it is same as before, as we have seen. So let me write over here. So I'll write the block alone. I'm neglecting the surrounding completely. So now I will I'll take two axes and I'm writing the forces on them. So one is F and the other forces must be there from the opposite direction. It is obvious to take an opposite force to this applied force because this is a rough surface, I told you. When the object is moving on the rough surface, there is a kinetic friction opposite to this applied force. Let me call that kinetic friction as Fk, which is given by mu k into N, where N is the normal reaction. Similarly, along the y-axis also, we have to take two forces. One is obviously the weight of the object and the other is this normal reactions. So we have taken or we have written the free body diagram. So now it is time to write the dynamic equations along the two directions, x and y. So along the x-axis, I told you it is accelerating along the x-axis. Therefore, the net force is not zero along the x-axis. Therefore, let me call the net force along the x-axis as M into A. This is obviously from the Newton's second law of motion. Any force on the object can be written as mass into its acceleration because it is accelerating with acceleration equal to A. So therefore, net force along the x-axis is MA, and this net force is given by the sum of these two things. So F plus this M, this is taken as negative because this force is along the negative x-axis. So therefore the net force is given by F minus mu k into N. So this is what the dynamic equation along the x-axis for this non-equilibrium case. Similarly, along y-axis it is obvious because there is no acceleration along the y-axis. I can write it as N minus mg is equal to 0. So these two examples are the simple cases which is showing us how to use the free body diagram. In the next video, we will be looking at a little more complex system such as two blocks on a surface which are in contact with each other and an external force is applied on them, and two blocks are connected with a massless and inextensible strings and they are pulled. So how to use the free body diagram in these cases, and we will be finding out the expression for this external force. So I hope you understood the concepts, and thank you for